And apparently they're looking for some replacement type therapies, but you've got a lot of information about that.
Sure, absolutely. As you know, when you have atrial fibrillation as a physician, the one thing that we are worried the most about is your risk of stroke. And there's a large body of evidence that show that those patients who have atrial fibrillation, as well as certain other risk factors, are at higher risk for having a stroke. One of the commonly used criteria that we used is something that's called the CHADS2 score, which is shown here. And the CHADS2 score is just a mnemonic to help us remember the additional risk factors. Those risk factors would include having heart failure, age greater than 75 years of age, high blood pressure, high blood sugar or type 2 diabetes mellitus, and a prior history of a stroke or a TIA. And we know that when you have more of these risk factors in addition to atrial fibrillation, your yearly risk of stroke increases. And that's best seen in this table here, where we can see that if you have a CHADS score of 0, your yearly risk of having a stroke is somewhere around 2%. And then with each additional point, your risk increases, we can see here. So as physicians, we try to figure out which medications are appropriate for your particular level of risk. If you, let's say, have zero risk factors for having a stroke with atrial fibrillation, then it's possible that aspirin therapy alone will be adequate. However, in general, if you have two or more risk factors, the national guidelines would say that we should use Coumadin, a blood thinner, to reduce your risk of stroke. And the benefit of Coumadin is roughly a two-thirds risk reduction in your yearly stroke risk.
So the CHADS2 risk criteria, what does that mean when people see CHADS2?
CHADS2 is, once again, it's just the mnemonic, and it's a way for physicians to essentially assess your level of risk. So there's a point-based system. So for if you have high blood pressure, diabetes, prior history of stroke, you get a point for each of those. Stroke, you actually get 2 points. And we use that point system then to assess what your yearly risk of having a stroke is.
Great.
When we look at this table, typically we can see here that if your CHADS score is less than 1, we typically recommend aspirin therapy only. However, when your CHADS score is greater than 2, we recommend Coumadin. And if you're at 2, it's really up to the physician's discretion as to whether or not we put you on aspirin therapy or Coumadin. Now, many patients who are taking Coumadin for atrial fibrillation to reduce their risk of stroke don't like taking it. And the reason why they don't like taking it is because there's what's called a narrow therapeutic window, which just basically means that we have to constantly monitor your blood thinness level. And that measurement is called an INR. And we measure that typically once every 2 weeks or once every month when a patient is on a stable dose of Coumadin. Now, the other problems with Coumadin is that patients don't like to take it because it often takes several days for the blood level to become thin enough, often 5 or 6 days of starting what's called a loading dose of Coumadin before your blood is adequately thinned. The other problems with Coumadin that patients don't like is that the dose can vary from patient to patient. So I have some patients who are on, for example, 2.5 milligrams of Coumadin a day, and some patients who are on 15 milligrams of Coumadin a day. And it's almost a trial and error that we have to use to get the right dose of Coumadin to get the right level of blood thinness, that 2.0 to 3.0 range of your INR level.